What's going on with it, man? You already know what it is and who it is, man. It's the masterpiece, mouthpiece, Sinful the P. Speaking so fluently and eloquently in the spectacular vernacular called realism, one more again. And before I even begin, allow me to get some information just in case if somebody decides to have a conversation with me later on. Just go to Instagram and put in S-I-N 2 underscores F-U-L. S-I-N 2 underscores F-U-L. Jump your big head ass right up in the DM and let me know. Sin, I come from the YouTube family. Also, on my Facebook, I'm going to bless you with my government and my pavement information. My government name is P-H-I-L-L-I-P-G-I-L-M-O-R-E. Pavement name, S-I-N-F-U-L-G-I-L-M-O-R-E. Philip Gilmore and Sinful Gilmore. On my Snapchat, it's only for the ladies, not for the fellas that desire to be ladies, had surgery to become a lady. For those who were born females and evolved into beautiful, infinite-minded women that's been attentive, you know what I mean, and also attractive, you know what I mean, definitely come on down to my Snapchat, man, S-I-N-F-U-L-T-H-E-P, and get at me. My website, www.sinfulthep.net. Hit the consultation button. Definitely won't be a disappointment, and make your appointment right now. But let me say this, man. You know, it's 2019. It's a brand new year. You know, a lot of shit that's been going on previously. You know what I mean? We need to stop that. You know, P, what you talking about? I'm talking about, you know, posting pictures of old traps, you know, posting videos, counting old traps, you know what I mean, posting videos and pictures, you know what I mean, with broads that don't make no money. She pretty as a motherfucker, fine as a motherfucker, but the bitch don't make no money, so she ugly as a motherfucker. Because truth of the matter is, all pimps is the same in this particular category. You know, a woman can start off by looking like Beyonce, you know what I mean, but if she ain't making no money, man, she gonna start looking like you don't say, you know what I mean, in a minute, you know what I mean? So, we all on one accord. Every pimp differently, you know, but we all desire to pimp accordingly, you know, and so in order to pimp accordingly, you can't get into a continuity of pursuing success in the game with somebody who is not using her ability to the best of her ability and making it a responsibility to fulfill the instructions that was given. That's a no-no. So, you know what I mean? Let me just say some things before I, you know, get into some testimonies, you know what I mean, of the game. If you right now have a woman or a group of women that you're presiding over, but, you know what I mean, you got 5 women, but you're making no woman type of money. You got 5 bitches, but you make 1 bitch, a nan bitch, you know, type of money. You know what I mean? Throw that away, man. Throw that away. You know what I mean? Some of you niggas, you know, you're posting pictures and videos in the game can't bless you because you're not being real. And by you projecting a fake image on social media, the game is omnipresent. So, you know, hypocrisy and Oscar award performances, the game is not going to reward that. Stop making these broke ass, disobedient, you know what I mean, faggot ass bitches famous on the gram, famous on the book, you know what I mean, just because of the way that they look, man. Some of you niggas got bitches that look like motherfucking, you understand me, a old young version, the back in the day version of Mariah Carey or A. Marie, you know what I mean. But as we can see, she's not making no currency, P. She's just attractive. You know what I mean? But you should have became less attentive the moment that she kept bringing in these 2s and 3s. You know what I mean? And you accepted it. You know, a lot of these bras be pulling, especially the ones that know that they attractive. I look too good for the track. You know, miss, I look too good to stay down 8 hours or more. Miss, you know what I mean? I look too good to be in jail. You know, and you niggas accept bitches like this. So by you accepting a bitch like this, you could never pimp on a bitch like that. Why? Because her mentality is contrary to the game. And the moment that you accepted that, you accepted that mentality. So you and the bitch right now currently is contrary to this game. Yeah, you accepted it. So of course, you know, I'm gonna tell you that, you know, times basically, you know, I mean, I done told you in times past when certain bitches done blew up on me. But I gotta tell you the truth, man, on when I blew up, you know what I mean, on certain bitches. I gotta tell you about certain times where certain bitches sit up there and did things, you know what I mean, and said things that make me blow up, such as not making no damn money. You know what I mean? Because I done been in some situations like, man, it can't get no worse than this. Surviving a broke bitch. You know what I mean? But I'm going to just sit up there, man, put some pain where it ain't and say what most can't, man. I remember, man, being on that west side of Chicago, you know what I mean, campaigning and obtaining, man, on that Washington and Kilbourne. And no disrespect to anybody else's reputation, but whenever I would come in a location, man, I noticed that I was the only one really coming through with some snow. And ain't no disrespect to nobody, because I'm not saying nobody else did, but during that time, nah, it wasn't no snow coming on Washington and Kilbourne. If you seen, you know what I mean, a white bitch, or you seen some old fake ass Faith Evans or Charlie Baltimore, you know, complexion type broad, you know, 9 out of 10, it was my bitch, especially if she was dressed right. Because even them niggas that had snow here and there, they didn't know, a lot of these niggas, they don't know how to dress. The bitch don't know how to dress herself, and the nigga don't know how to dress the bitch either. So she just come out looking a fool, and her money is very foolish. So, you know, and looking at the way he dressed her, very understandable. But, okay, check this out. So, basically, at this time, right, you know what I mean? It's 15 and 16 below zero. It's cold as a motherfucker. I got this one bitch. She go to jail like it's the thing to do. She go to jail like she been commissioned by God to go to jail. This bitch would go to jail like 2 to 3 times a week, man. You know what I mean? Real talk. And her money was funny. Her change was strange. But, and you going to jail, too? God damn, bitch, you got to pick a struggle. Now, the other bitch, she's, you know, Peruvian and Jewish, and she's damn near 6 feet tall, got a little shape on her, you know what I mean, pretty, but, you know, she got epilepsy, so, and in this type of weather, she's pretty much having seizures all the fucking time, you know what I mean, so one bitch going in and out of jail like it's the thing to do, and another bitch that's having seizures, you know, damn near every day, so, this is a very fucked up time for me, because, you know, the nigga Freeze is locked up. Freeze just got locked up. Freeze up in that damn Virginia. And he called me and said, bro, get me the fuck out of here. Because, you know what I mean, chances are they're going to bring him more allegations. And as you know, as they put up more allegations, their whole purpose of bringing them allegations is to stack my bail so I can't get a chance of getting out of here. So the time to move on this shit is now. So, you know what I mean, I got the pressure, you know what I mean, of getting my brother immediately, you know what I mean, out of jail, because I don't want them to stack the bail all the way up to the heavens. You know what I mean? I got to move immediately. And these bitches ain't making no goddamn currency. You know, and anybody know me, I'm an egotistical motherfucker. You know what I mean? Only one that I have ever asked for some money from, you know, accept the jugs and pretty much, you know what I mean, a call to get a jug from is free. So, you know, as far as asking another P for some, hell the fuck no. Even with all of the pimps that I've jugged and helped out, I've never called anybody that I helped out, bailed out, and asked them for anything. Why? Because I'm sinful to Pete. So, you gotta understand my mentality. You know, but Pete, he dry this, or Pete, he live here, or Pete, he been in the game for such a, but I'm still sinful to Pete. When I see them niggas, all I see is my little brothers with toys. And that's good. I congratulate them. The toys are their accomplishment. But mentally, these are still my little brothers. I'm not going to ask them for no goddamn money. So, you know, I'm like, man, I got to motherfucking pimp up, man. Goddamn. So, right after I get off the phone with Freeze, because I got to tell the truth. The fucking trap between both of these bitches, the room is eating that up. Then I got to still feed these two big head motherfuckers. Then I got to sit up there and put money on the phone for when Freeze call. And you know it's fucked up when you active in the game, you're not incarcerated, you're not locked up, Pete. And I understand we eat top ramen when we want to, but I just got to be real with you. I was not eating top ramen at this particular time because I wanted to. I was eating top ramen at this time because I had to. You know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? I'm just keeping that shit all the way 100 with you. I know everybody like to talk the in the cloud stories and shit, but I'm telling you, man, that situations like this, I'm telling you, man, the surviving a broke bitch. You know what I mean? I'm giving you this real. And at this particular time, I remember one night, man, I was so frustrated. I didn't know what to do, man, because I gave the coldest motivational speech ever. I know you can relate. You know what I mean? You know when you lacing some brides up, you know what I mean, and giving a cold motivational speech, And, you know, man, you like, man, Malcolm can't even mess with this. Farrakhan couldn't even mess with this, man. Like, Lee couldn't even mess with this, man. Like, this is the coldest motivational speech that has ever been given. You ever had a conversation with these broads and you expound and you say something so profound to where you amazed at the shit that proceeded out your mouth to the point you almost chose yourself? You know what I mean? So that... I was like, man, I know these bitches about to make some money now. Oh, yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah, I already know, man. They about to sit up there and make some money now. Man, I lied to you not. Pete, the bitch that go to jail, like, it's her ministry to go to jail. Why this bitch called me less than an hour? You have a call from. I can explain. Less than an hour, bro. I lied. I kid you not. Less than an hour, bro. So... you know what I mean? She get locked up. You know what I mean? I'm upset. I'm mad as hell. You know what I mean? I remember like yesterday. I remember like... and the other bitch, you know what I mean, with epilepsy. She sit up there and catch a little $150 date. I'm like, okay, that's a little progress. But right after she catches the date on her way coming back to the track, she has a seizure right in front of the trick. You know what I mean? I'm like, oh my God damn. You know what I mean? She's like, oh my God. Oh, can I just come in? You know what I mean? For a little bit. You know what I mean? And I don't mean to sound heartless, but I got to give it to you the way it is. I can't fix the story up to make shit sound good because some bitch might see it. And I'm trying to paint myself to be, oh my God, Sin really cared. No, I got to give you the 100. My name is Sinful, bitch. It's not pretty this, gorgeous that, free. It's none of that. It's Sinful. And it's that for a reason. My brother is locked up and fucked up. So yes, this bitch is having seizures, but she need to have a seizure to another motherfucking date because I'm sitting over there trying to accumulate some money to get my brother out of motherfucking jail and shit. You know what I mean? So I know that y'all like, damn, Sin, that's foul. But my brother locked up and fucked up, and they trying to stack up more charges and allegations and shit against my brother to keep my brother locked up. And these charges, man, you know, they trying to make it acting as if they about to get federal on my brother, man. So, you know, I understand what the bitch is going through, but, you know, I mean, I'm going to give you another motivational speech. We're going to be prayerful, and we hope that God be merciful while you on the motherfucking track and, you know, stay in a hoe's place, which is in a trick's face, and catch another motherfucking date, you know what I mean, and another one, and another one. And if you just so happen to have a motherfucking seizure, you know what I mean, just make sure that you didn't broke the trick, seduce and reduce this motherfucking ass, and, you know, sit up there and catch another one, and another one, and another one. That was my mentality at that time. And I know the women go, dislike, fuck this nigga, but I gotta give you the real. I can't make shit up. So, you know, I call around, you know what I mean, see, because this bitch supposed to be out of jail at this particular time, you know, now. And I'm sitting over there calling around, man, because the bitch, her phone going to voicemail. The bitch that just went to jail, her phone going to voicemail. So I was like, this bitch ain't charged up her phone. So, I called, you know, her mom, you know, me and her mom, you know, was cool. She liked me. So I sit up there and I call her mom. It's like, you know, you heard from her? Because by now, you know what I mean? It's the evening time. The next day, she should have been out. But come to find out, when the bitch got out of jail, you know what I mean? They sat up there and arrested the bitch again. You know, because the attire that she had on when she was walking out, she was talking to somebody and they said, let us talk. Now, watch how stupid this bitch is. They sit up there, the police, they fucking with her. They trying to. That's what the police do. They want to, you know, start a conversation to give you that motivation to put you out of character and put you in your anger so you can emotionally react and not mentally respond so you can say something either incriminating or disrespectful where they lock you up. So, you know what I mean, the police is on their job, the bitch ain't on hers. So, they sit up there, you know what I mean, hey, come here. And so she come in an attitude, why? You know what I mean, come here. So, the police, they sit up there and they talking to her. This bitch end up cursing out the police, you know what I mean, and all of this shit. And she talking to the police, fine. They end up locking her ass up again. That type of shit, right? And so now I'm in my room because I done sent this bitch back outside. And remind you now, it's 15 to 16 below zero. It'd be days where I would open the door and feel the cold. You know what I mean? And be like, man, better you bitch than me. It was her, I'm sending her back out into the cold. And now I'm in my room like, God damn, is this really my life? You know what I mean? Like, I remember, you know what I mean? 2 seconds ago, man, I was on the West Coast. You know what I mean? I had a little bit over 20,000. You know what I mean? I was 4 deep. You know, am I really, you know, in this room right now? On the west side of Chicago? Am I really, you know what I mean, at this motherfucking room where it looked like Martin Luther King got killed and I'm eating Top Ramen soups and both of these bitches together, you know what I mean, is not making anything close to decent. I was like, is this really my life? I was like, and then my brother is facing these charges and I can't be a blessing to him the way that I want to be a blessing to him. This shit is beneath me. So instead of me, you know, playing with this situation, I had them little broads, you know what I mean, come back. And once they set up there, you know, once the bitch got out of jail, she come. And now I got the little Peruvian bitch. I sit them down. I say, listen, man, where y'all want to go? Because we can't do this. And he's like, what you mean, Sin? What you mean we can't? I'm like, no, we not going to do this. That's one thing I'm not going to do. I'm not going to disrespect myself. I'm not going to disrespect my time. I'm not going to disrespect this game. And the shit that you guys been bringing in, you know what I mean? It's not, you know, and baby, I understand your health condition, you know, and I'm not going to say encourage you to get out of the game. But as of right now, in this particular area, you know, in this circumstance, you know, what I'm going to do for you is I'm going to basically give you some numbers to some pimps, and you can, you know, choose within the pimping who you want to be with. It's a lot of pimps that would still want you in your circumstance. Oh my God, Sin, you going to give me away? You going to give me away just because I got epilepsy? I'm like, no, I'm not giving you away because you have epilepsy. I'm giving you away because, you know, there's another pimp, you know, who's used to having one hoe or close to one, or, you know, I mean, a hoe or an impossible, you know, and he can deal with and preside over you better in different weather. And I think that you need to be out there on the West Coast or somewhere, you know, with another one of my partners, you know, who really not deep, and he can, he got the time and he got the patience to pretty much, you know what I mean, deal with your situation. Me, I'm young and energetic, and because I got to get my brother out of jail, you know, no disrespect to your feelings and your circumstance, but I got to get him out of jail, baby. And you know, right now we just in two different lanes, you know. So I just want to be a blessing to the game, but giving you an opportunity to choose somebody else. Oh my God, I can't believe that you giving me away. I can't believe that you giving me away. And then the other bitch with the nerve, Miss, I go to jail like it's the thing to do. She sit up there and say, well, I ain't going nowhere. You know, we gonna be together, you know, forever. Like my loyalty is with you, and that's who it's gonna stay with. I said, no, you know, I'm going to sit up there, man, and put you on the line with some pimping as well. I ain't going to talk to him. So I separated them bitches, you know what I mean? And the one that missed, I ain't going to talk to him. I put her on the line, you know what I mean, with some pimping, you know what I mean? And I sat up there and was doing things on purpose. Anybody know me know I'm cold. So I'm manipulating the bitch. I'm like, man, honestly, even when I first got you, I knew that you was, you know, better off with him. You know what I mean? I always thought to myself, I said, man, you know what I mean? Even though, you know what I mean, I'm enjoying my time, I ain't gonna lie, she remind me of woo. You just be better with his program. She's like, I don't know. Miss, I won't talk to him. Now she's saying, I don't know. So, but anyway, make a long story short, he ended up having the big head bitch and took that motherfucking problem off me. And, you know, he was happy with the little $300-$400 that the bitch could give every now and then. You know, the bitch was a cancer to me. The bitch wasn't doing nothing but slowing me down. Take that bitch and get the fuck on, man. 1, 2, 3, no take backs. Okay, but Yeah, you it. So, you know what I mean? Miss Epilepsy, you know what I mean? Well, we just ended up, you know, departing. You know what I mean? No hard feelings, you know what I mean? But I can't do this. You know what I mean? So what I did was, with the little change that I had, you know, on me, you know what I mean? I only had a little bit of $3, man, $300-something, man. So I called, this is the first time, man, I called Pease. I said, let's come on one accord, you know what I mean, to get Freeze out of jail. Because right now, you know what I mean, man, I'm in between bitches right now, man. It ain't looking too good for a P right now, man. But it's looking good because I am a P. But what's happening? Oh, P, man, I got you, man. I got you, man. Now watch this. That social media shit, don't believe in that. You know what I mean? Because it be niggas that be counting old traps. Niggas that's putting up pictures and videos. And you just think that the nigga over there doing good. Nigga over there doing just as bad as you is. Oh, P, I should have something. Woo, woo. And then you had some that was doing decent. You actually had some niggas that was doing decent or better. But due to the fact that they just didn't look out for the game. One nigga at this particular time, even though he always lied about his numbers, niggas know who I'm talking about. He was in Vegas, you know what I mean? He'll be deep. But he knew how to make a 2 or 3 bitch trap, you know, look and appear, you know, to be bigger than what it is. Because in Vegas, you know, a lot of niggas put on Oscar award performances and shit, acting like they're doing something bigger than what they're doing. Not everybody, but majority, yeah. You know, a lot of them niggas in Vegas got you guys fooled into thinking that they really doing some pimping because of the little foreigns that they got on gangster deals or the house that they got on the gangster deal. But in all actuality, you know what I mean? It ain't no real currency being spent, you know, on this shit. But, I mean, I can't be mad at them. If you on the outside looking in and you trying to choose a situation and the end destination is failure, then that's shame on you. I don't feel bad for you for choosing up on the situation because you were supposed to choose some pimping any goddamn way that was producing some uncommon information. So if you came to a situation that appeared to look good on Instagram or Facebook, I don't give a fuck how it end with you because, you know what I mean, that's how it was supposed to do. You reap what you sow and you reap what you don't sow. And you didn't sow no horns. So you didn't reap, you know, off the benefits of fucking with pimping. So, you know, getting back to this game, man, you know, I was able to sit up there and get enough change to get my brother out, you know what I mean? Another situation, man, before I end this, you know what I mean, because I was happy to get my brother, he got his liberty back in society, but I had to collaborate with the pimping in order for me to do it, man, because a situation like this, man, and endeavoring to survive a broke bitch, you know what I mean, you know, if I kept on with that particular situation, it would have took me forever and a day to get my brother out. And my brother needed to be out like that. So I had to make something happen. So, you know, that's the only time where I ever called pimps for help concerning, you know, anything. Because no pimp in the game could ever say that, yeah, Sin just called me for a jug or Sin called me for some help. No. You know what I mean? Only time I ever sit up there and ask for help is when Freeze was locked up, and at that time I was temporarily fucked up. But like I say, you know what I mean? A pimp could be delayed, but a pimp can never be denied. What's to come is definitely better than what's been. I'm going to tell you about another situation before I end this. I don't want to say, you know, a name because I don't want to make this punk famous, but this particular bitch, if you in the game, she keeps my name out of her mouth all the time, because that's her claim to fame. Bitch ain't famous for doing no horn. She just famous for, I used to pay Sinful to pee. You know what I mean? Even in her obituary, it's going to say she was born from Henry, Michelle, year, birth, went to grammar school, graduated out of high school, end up meeting Sinful Pete, Sinful to pee, hold for Sinful to pee. After that, no success, the end, dead. You know what I mean? That's pretty much her obituary. Every conversation that she have with any representation or anybody that's outside of the game, within that conversation, within the first 300 seconds of that conversation, Sinful the P will be mentioned. But anyway, make a long story short, you know, her money was funny and her change was strange too. And, you know, at this particular time, man, you know what I mean? I just got out, so I'm endeavoring to have it. So, yeah, I'm going hard on that bitch. You know, I got on Boulder Highway endeavoring to do it my way. So, you know, the bitch, you know, she'll come back with some cool little eights and nines. But, you know, when you don't have shit, reality is that ain't shit. You know what I mean? I need you to stay down all day, the next day, and another day after that. Hell, you need to stay down to Adolf Hitler come back as a good man. You know what I mean? I'm really trying to have it around this motherfucker. So, you know, I'm not a nigga that asks for jugs. And why ask for a jug and it's billions of bitches on the planet? So, you know, when I got out, I didn't have anything. So I ended up getting this little piece of a little white bitch. And, you know what I mean? We on Boulder and shit. And she like, oh my God, sin. Because at this time, man, she had been out. I mean, of course, she'll come in. I let her eat a little bit, get some water, take a little hour or two nap, then send that bitch right back out the door. And this had went on for like a good 3-4 days. And then all of a sudden, man, her money started to get a little funny, you know what I mean? And it began to drop. And, you know, because she was like, please, Sin, just let me come in. If you let me come in, you know what I mean, and get some energy, you know what I mean? I'm going to be able to, you know, go out and go make, you know, something for you. I was like, bitch, you know what I mean? That sounds like some manipulation, you know what I mean, to have some sleep. If you really wanted some sleep, you know what I mean, you would have sat up there and brought me something by now. You know what I mean? That's Boulder Highway. And this is at the time where Boulder Highway was still cracking. You know what I mean? Now it's just pretty much nothing but cracker toots. You know what I mean? But anywhere where it's some traffic, you know what I mean? If a broad, especially if she's Caucasian and dressed for the occasion, man, she should be able to make some accumulation in that location where traffic is coming, nigga. Anywhere where a bitch put her feet down on concrete, that's a blade. Money supposed to be being made. That's just being real. So, the bitch sit up there, you know what I mean? Oh my God, Sin, my legs is about to fall off. I said, I'm at the store, man, you know, buying you some new legs right now. I said, but in the meantime, man, catch another date. So by the time I get to the blade, man, you know, with your new legs, you know, man, you'll have some more money. Oh my God, Sin, don't you take anything serious. I can't stand you. Oh, I can't stand this shit. Oh, oh. So instead of the bitch blowing up and choosing a pimp or a simp, you know, or a gangster or whatever, this bitch blow up to the goddamn police. You know what I mean? Because she wasn't making no money. Or because she called herself, thinking that I'm going too hard. But in reality, you know what I mean? You're going too soft. And I'm trying to have it all. So, you know, reality is, you know what I mean? She bitch sit up there and go to Metro. And she tell Metro everything. You know what I mean? And at that time, you know, a partner of mine, you know, from the shot, GD nigga, you know what I mean? Bro, he's sitting over there, you know what I mean? In the room, back at my room, and he called me while I was gambling, because I'm trying to basically, that's when you know when a bitch ain't made no money. And I know this can relate to a lot of you niggas, because a lot of times when the bitches or the bitch ain't making no money, you niggas try to sit up there and go to the casino and gamble and try to basically make what the bitch didn't make. And that's not pimping. That's contrary to the spirit of pimping. Trying to go to the casino and make. I didn't even see niggas think that that was pimping. Like, man, I done made more than the bitch made tonight. Or, man, I done made as much as the bitch made tonight. Yeah, nigga, and that ain't nothing to brag about in this pimping. That's something that a square would say. Square ass nigga. But make a long story short, my contrary ass at the time, I'm up in the motherfucking casino and shit, you know what I mean, trying to sit up there and gamble up, trying to make what the bitch ain't make. I'm not aware that she done got the police involved. My nigga hit me, you know what I mean, and he like, man, bro, the police here, they knocking on the door, man, saying your government name. I said, what? I said, nigga, where you at? He said, man, I'm under the bed. I was like, nigga, you under the bed? And this nigga, you know what I mean, I ain't gonna say his name, of course. This nigga got bodies. This nigga known for being with the shit. And the police got this nigga under the bed. But that's another story. So, at this time, because of me gambling and losing the little change that I have, now I'm all the way down to $187. I think it's a change. It was either $183 or $187. But if I was a betting man, I'd say $187. So I tell Freeze the situation, man. I'm like, man, this bitch done set up there, man. Not only blew up, but bro, she done put the police in my goddamn business, man. It's just fucked up. He said, P, you got to get out of there, man. You got to get out of here, man. You got to get out of this Vegas. I said, I know. So I found the little flight, you know what I mean? Got out of Vegas, you know what I mean? Hit that motherfucking Long Beach, you know what I mean? I found the nice little flight, man, that was $180 or $81 or $82. But when I got off that plane, I had less than $5 in my pocket, you know what I mean? So chances are I probably was like $181. I mean, well, pretty much $183. Or, you know, 182 and some change. Because, you know, if it was 187, then yeah, it would have to be pretty much 182 and some change. So when I got off, you know what I mean, the plane, I got pretty much less than $5. I called every bitch on my phone, every Renegade, every Square, and said, hey, if you want to sit up there, man, and keep talking to me, or want to ever keep texting me or whatever, if you ever want to see me again, you need to have a reunion with Western Union. See, that's the difference between me and these niggas. When I got into circumstances and situations, the only situation where I basically was assisted by the pimping was to get my brother out. But me personally, on my own, no. You know what I mean? I've never called, that's just me. You know what I mean? I called the Squares. I called these Renegades. I called these strippers. I called, you know what I mean, ex-hoes. So I'm sitting over there, you know what I mean, fucked up. But, you know what I mean, after talking to a few bitches, okay, saying I ain't got nothing really right now, but I'm going to catch some dates later on tonight. And then we're even the Squares. I got a little money right now. I ain't going to say your name, but you know I always got love for you, baby. You know what I mean? She looked out, you know what I mean, for a pimp. Miss, I ain't going to never, I don't want to be no hoe. But every time, it was situations in times past, you know what I mean, the game used the bitch to be a blessing to a pimp when I was in between bitches. So, you know, I'm always going to have love, you know what I mean, for your big head ass bitch. But anyway, she have a reunion at Western Union, you know what I mean, and now, you know what I mean, I got enough change to sit up there and check into the La Quinta. And, you know what I mean, and during that time, I ended up, you know what I mean, getting some fly-by nights and, you know, man, bitches is making twos and threes and just enough money to pay for the room, get some food, you know what I mean, that type of shit, you know what I mean, a pimp trying to pimp up, you know what I mean, for a rental, pimp trying to pimp up, you know what I mean, to sit up there, man, and pay certain bills and shit, you know what I mean, that I'm behind on by now, and finally, man, the game done blessed me. I ended up, you know what I mean, talking to this bitch at the time that was in Charlotte, North Carolina, and she came out of nowhere, man, you know what I mean, she got on my Facebook, got on the timeline, and I'll never forget, she said, So, you know what I mean, she got on my timeline, said that shit, and you know what I mean, I get up in the inbox, I said, you know what I mean, what's all of that? You know, matter of fact, no, you know, scratch that, that's incorrect, I didn't get into the inbox, I got on the status and pretty much put a question mark and said, you know, what's happening? Well, I'm interested, I want to talk to you, so we exchanged information, had a conversation pretty much all night, you know what I mean, and first trap she sent a little tiny little gift of $500, then she sent another little $500, you know what I mean, and then she finally said, you know what, you know what I mean, I'm ready to fuck with you, and once she set up there, you know what I mean, and fuck with me, she damn near, it was almost, you know what I mean, pretty much like 89 or some change, but it wasn't 9,000 to, you know, to be exact. You know, a lot of niggas be lying. But no, it wasn't 9,000 to be exact. But she emptied out her whole bank account to fuck with a pimp, though. You know what I mean? So she gave me that little A-Racks and some change. And show you how the game worked after getting her. You know what I mean? Because I sat up there, you know what I mean, and checked it out her motherfucking ass. You know what I mean? For damn near 2 months before we physically seen each other. And then I ended up, you know what I mean, knocking this other nigga that, you know, from New York, but was doing this thing in Orlando, knocked him for the little broad, and, you know, that little broad that I ended up getting from him, you know what I mean, that's the one that the nigga special, which I'm still cool with today, that's the bitch that special ended up knocking me. I told you, pimping is a blessing to pimping, and because I came into the door, you know, at that time, telling her that my fee was $5,000, you know what I mean, when I got knocked for the bitch, because the way I pimp, you know what I mean, P was able to come behind me and say, you know what I mean? Well, you know, if you gave him five, you know, I need my 10. And I'm always going to respect my nigga Special for that. Blessings to Special and blessings to Denver. You know what I mean? But I had checked over, you know what I mean, 20,000 before me and that broad physically seeing each other. Even though I said the fee was only 5,000, you know what I mean? But by, you know, me sending the bitch to different areas to go get it and all of this shit and coming up, you know, because at that time, you know, hold on. At that time, you know what I mean, I was moving the bitch, you know what I mean, from Connecticut, moving the bitch to Minnesota, you know, moving her all around in New York, you know what I mean, Boston, you know. So, you know what I mean, the bitch was sitting over there getting my money. Then I still got the bitch in Charlotte, you know what I mean, and so the game, man, you know, blessed, put a pimp back in position. Next thing you know, man, you know what I mean, I was five deep, you know what I mean, with bitches, you know what I mean, in each and every motherfucking state and shit like that. But prior to that, I was still on that west side. Prior to that, I was still eating Top Ramen soup. Prior to that, I was in 15 and 16 below zero weather. Prior to that, you know what I mean, I was thinking to myself, is my situation gonna get any better? You know what I mean? This is a fucked up situation, man. Situations like this, fuck it, man. You know what I mean? The surviving of a broke bitch. You know what I'm saying? And I could go on and on and on, man. This ain't even going to be my last video with this shit. This is just part one. But I hope you guys live as long as you want, man, and never want as long as you live. But I just wanted to chop it up with y'all, man. I love you. You know, make sure you hit the share button. Make sure you hit the like button. Share this on Facebook, Instagram. I got more content for y'all, man. I love y'all. I'm going to wrap it up, you know, man, because the time is building up. And I don't want to sit up there and go too long. You know, people see the time and be like, man, you know what I mean? So I end it right now, man. But it definitely going to be a part two of this because I got too many, man, stories, man, of how a nigga was from here and then just pimped up, pimped up, pimped up. Like I said, if you really standing on your pimping and you don't give up your balls to ball and you got principles about yourself, it's going to be some slow days. It's going to be some no days. It's going to be some adversities in this shit because reality is, if a nigga ain't never sit up there, you understand me, and been holeless and doleless before, chances are that he probably never pimped. If a nigga ain't never leaked in this shit, chances are he has never pimped. I hope you guys live as long as you want and never want as long as you live. Surviving of a broke bitch.